Welcome to the Sea Dogs Arena. Crew one of our glorious ships and compete against rivals to earn silver. Seek out glory by following the Sea Dogs' beacons. Dig up our chests, and some silver will be yours. More silver awaits for those who bring these chests to Sea Dog agents found within the arena. Damage rival ships, and we will also grant you silver. There is one final way to win silver. Send your rivals to the Ferry of the Damned. Beware! Should your ship meet a watery grave, it will cost you silver. Once the contest is over, the crew with the most silver will be victorious. All crews are rewarded after a contest. The higher you place, the more gold and reputation you will receive. May good fortune and glory await.
If you want to be the best, talk to the best. Yeah. Wait! You didn't take the big dog's business scroll. Thank you.
Another new face. That was quite the celebration when you arrived. I'm not surprised you don't remember it. The Pirate Lord told me to expect you. I hope you are prepared for the adventure that awaits, and the danger. You'll need gold if you're to prosper, but there are ways to see to that. Several trading companies have a presence across the Sea of Thieves. Here on this outpost, you can meet with the Gold Hoarders, the Merchant Alliance, and the Order of Souls. Don't be fooled. These aren't the stuffy bureaucrats you're used to from the wider world. They'll readily pay pirates who are willing to take on work. Make yourself known, and they'll offer you voyages to prove yourself. Think of them as an initiation, or a way to make coin, if you prefer. You'll find your ship waiting outside, as well as food and supplies, if you know where to look. When you're ready for a greater challenge, come back and speak with me again.
Got any stories to share? My door's always open.
What's on the horizon today? Go wherever the wind carries you.
Let me fill that tankard of yours. Welcome to the Unicorn. My door's always open.
Hello, my lovely.
Bye-bye, dearie.
Yeah, what? Working here is so unfair.
Help you? Thanks.
Gold? Chests. Get.
How nice to see you. I wish you great fortune.
Exotic items here, pirate! Remember to sort your coins by size. Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome to Autolog, the connected heart of Need for Speed Hot Pursuit. Autolog puts friends at the center of your game, allowing you to easily connect, compare, and compete with all your friends playing Need for Speed. Hot Pursuit Online is where you connect and compete with up to 7 other players, earning bounty towards your cop or racer careers. Head into Seacrest County to earn bounty and progress your career as either a cop or a racer in solo events. Autolog Recommends is an all-new innovation in social competition. Here, Autolog recommend events to you based on what your friends have been playing. To get started right away, head into the career. Play against anyone or set up a personal match with friends, cop or racer, you decide.
Thank you. Seacrest County has become the ultimate place to speed. A playground for the most exotic cars and drivers in the world. But this is not a lawless place. Constant competition has led to the creation of the world's fastest police force, Seacrest County Speed Enforcement. The SCPD spare no expense to redline it all the way and make you pay. Every day, new drivers still show up and attempt to tame Seacrest County and outrun the law. The pursuit for the ultimate drive starts here. Which side are you on?
Entry in the Roadsters Reborn race event is confirmed. In this showcase event, you will unleash the true potential of the Roadster as you compete against other drivers in a race along the Seacrest County coast. Use your driving skills to outmaneuver the opposition and take a medal. Your reputation is measured in wanted levels. Currently, you are not registering much activity and are classed by the SCPD as a level 1 speeder. The greatest drivers win the races and outrun the law with style, and are classified as level 20, most wanted. Your daily activity is measured as bounty. The harder, faster, and more dangerously you drive, the more bounty you will earn. Win races, beat your rivals, and stay one step ahead of the cops to increase your wanted level and get access to new cars and entry into the toughest events. Your car is equipped with a race spec nitro system. Use this system to gain a rapid acceleration increase. Nitros will only charge if you drive dangerously. Drive in oncoming traffic lanes, near miss other vehicles, drift corners, and take shortcuts to gain the most nitros. This race has restricted entry requirements. You can choose any of the available cars to drive in the race. Some cars are locked at this time and will become available as you increase your wanted level.
Porsche engineers have realized a long-held dream. The dream of a Roadster that is more original, more sporty, and more liberated than ever. By taking an idea back to the basics, the Boxster Spider is based on a pure, lightweight design with no comfortable extras. Featuring a tuned version of the proven 3.4-liter flat-six Boxster engine, which sits just ahead of the rear axle, the Boxster Spider weighs only 1,275 kilograms. There is a noticeable kick in acceleration when compared to the other two models in the range, and the car is always alert and willing to change direction. No air conditioning, no radio, no cup holders, no door release levers. This is the lightest Porsche you can buy, and one that returns... RX-8 was launched in 2003 and is built...
Thank you.
Horatio Pagani and his team have once again created a piece of art able to speed over 350.
Your car has been installed with the latest anti-pursuit technology, the Spike Strip. Based on SCPD technology, the system releases a lethal spiked strip from the rear of your car. If another vehicle drives over the strip, they will be damaged and temporarily immobilized. Use the moment well and make your move. Your vehicle can only carry a limited number of strips and will take time to recharge after each use. So only fire when you are confirmed a hit. Your heads-up display will let you know when the system is online.
suspect is driving across the lane.
Originating?
Thank you. So far the name of the school is AJ's Racing Academy, but I don't know. How's it look on a t-shirt? What do you think, kid?
What happens when you combine street racing and off-road terrain?
Off-street road terrain racing.
No. Huh. You get Ultracross, a high-speed discipline on custom-made tracks designed for fast cars and even faster drivers.
What does that even mean? The person is going faster than the car?
Can I get back to explaining this, or do we have to talk physics?
All right, carry on.
These events emphasize pack racing, with wide turns and S-bends to test your cornering, long straights to get your speed up, and crossovers so you can see just how far ahead you are.
Thank you.
definitely not making any friends out there. And keep the aggression, because that'll help you get the wins, but just make sure you don't push things too far.
Ice, it's smooth, flat, and cold, and the only thing between you and the depths of the abyss.
Also, great in a soda to make it really crisp.
Good point. Ice, friend and enemy.
Icebreakers are for drift specialists with sweeping corners and long straights custom-built for sweet sideways action.
You gotta stay cool and keep control on a surface with very little grip.
I get it. Cool, as in ice.
Dude, I told you, stop explaining my jokes. It ruins the effect.
Here we are, closing.
see that? Events like these, that's what we're after. The big, headline-grabbing showstoppers. But they don't just let anyone enter, not even if AJ asks very nicely. So how do I get that golden ticket, I hear you ask? Well, my friend, you gotta work your magic elsewhere. You were in a race here, you get your reputation there, and generally just do the absolute best you can. Well, yeah, that happened. Here I am explaining how it works, and there you go, boom, main event.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Dirt Podcast by Donut Media. It's me, James Pumphrey, and as always, I'm joined by my handsome co-host, Nolan Sykes.
Thank you, I'm flattered.
It is race weekend, people! Toot toot! We got Jamie Chadwick on the line coming all the way from Nevada. W Series champion, everybody. No need for an intro. Jamie, what is going on in the land of dice and desert lizards?
Hey, James, how are you? Yeah, I'm in Nevada. It's super cool here. It's obviously a little bit noisy, but it's the big race coming up this weekend, and honestly, I can't wait.
Yeah, it sounds super noisy out there. Are you racing?
No, sadly not. It's a rare weekend off for me, but yeah, I'm here supporting AJ, actually. I've heard he's going to be out practicing soon, so I might go try and sneak a little look if I can.
Oh, AJ, close personal friend of the show and myself. He came to my wedding. Don't mean to brag. So you're a big fan as well?
Oh, massive fan. Guilty as charged there. I think he's so exciting to watch. Yeah, really one of the crowd's favorites. I also love how he's bringing up younger racers as well. It's so cool to see, and yeah, obviously a big fan.
So, Jamie, you're known for your open wheel racing career. What is it about the dirt that attracts you to the sport?
I think what I love is the unpredictable nature. You know, you're always racing on different surfaces, everything's changing, there's such cool features, there's jump. For us, I don't want to say it's boring, but it's very, very sort of monotonous. It's always the same, whereas I love the fact it's always changing for you guys in dirt, and yeah, it's so cool to see it makes the racing that bit more exciting.
Speaking of unpredictable, AJ is known for a slightly unpredictable, some might even say risky style of driving. How do you think that plays out in the heat of competition?
I mean, it works for him. I think that's the thing. For some drivers, it just doesn't work and they crash out and they have incidences. But for AJ, he seems to manage the risk really well. He calculates it and he gets away with it, and it's cool to see him go for gaps that I don't think exist, but he makes it happen, and yeah, it's why he's drawn in the big crowds this weekend.
So you think he's going to do pretty well this weekend then?
It goes without saying for me. I'm obviously in Nevada. I think if I were to put my money on anyone, it's on AJ, and yeah, fingers crossed he can have a good race.
Now moving on to the other side of the coin, a guy on the top of everyone's mind, a little guy named Bruno Duran. What are your thoughts on Bruno?
I mean, Bruno's got a lot of talent. It goes without saying. I think love him or hate him, whatever you think, he's got a little bit of a chip on his shoulder, but I mean, he's got talent and no one could deny that.
Yeah, but he's kind of like a, you know what I'm saying? He's kind of a...
Yeah,
kind of
but come on, everyone has different styles and no one's going to be the same. Not everyone's AJ, sadly, but yeah, everyone's got different styles and this is the way he's gone out to get results, and yeah, all credit to him, he's driving well.
Well, Jamie, when you hang up your racing gloves, I think you should run for office because you're very good at not answering questions.
All right, we won't disparage you too much. Jamie Chadwick, thank you so much for calling in on the show. Have a lovely weekend off in Nevada.
Don't lose all your money.
Cheers, thanks guys. Big fan of the podcast as well.
Thank you so much.
Jamie, Chadwick, everybody, we're going to take care of some sponsorship stuff, and we will be right back. Popular in the U.S. of A. USA! USA! Sprint cars are high-powered, open-frame race cars designed primarily to turn left.
And occasionally right.
But mostly left.
They run on short ovals or circular dirt tracks, and strapping yourself into one of these takes no small amount of courage.
If you like power, dirt, and going sideways, sprint racing is most definitely for you.
I love the wheels.
Same. If you want different sized tires on every single one of your wheels, Sprint's got you covered, baby.